Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Astroneers. And on tonight's episode, we're going to be continuing where we left off. Now, last episode, we had a little bit of trouble there at the end. I was trying to fadangle this thing into place. This is the massive solar reactor that we had found at the very beginning of the game that has to be connected to a rover. It can't be connected to a truck. It has to be a rover. And it has to be in the right spot. It has to be close enough and yet far enough away. And I wanted it down in the hole so it didn't move around when the wind blew. And if I drove over here, I didn't have to worry about pushing it by accident. I actually covered up a good bit of it. And you can see right there, the dirt actually, incorporated it into itself, and it still works just fine. So I think you could actually cover up most of this down here on the bottom and it would still be fine. But I want the look of it. I want you to see that it is like a crashed solar reactor from a satellite of some sort, and it works just fine. It actually pumps out a lot of power from what I can tell. So one of the other things that some of you guys have said, Dark Dragon in particular, let me know that you could actually put these storage panels on here on top of the V-shaped storage panel itself, and you can carry even more items with you. That is fantastic to know. That's something we're gonna have to do when we go back to our planet, and I'm gonna take this capsule with us as well if I possibly can get it on there. However, it is gonna take up a good amount of space to do just that. So if you see, we can put that one right there, and what I'll end up doing is taking that down into the base that we had built kind of at the end of our tether and creating that. Now I do want the solar reactor. I should have left that there. I didn't even think about it at the time, but I want the solar reactor there, and I need some items. We're not going to use these aluminum ones. It would have been nice to take with us, but what we really need is compound and resin. Now, we need 3 resin just to kind of get started. We're going to need a lot more than that to kind of finish it up, so I'm going to go ahead and take off the aluminum. We're not going to use that to start with either. And in fact, now we're going to go get the resin first. I was going to say, if we figure out what we need, we can just take exactly those items. Where's my truck? There it is over there. So let's take the truck back. I am going to, you know what? No, we're going to try something else. Something else that you guys have been meaning for us to give a shot is to use the coal that we have been finding, which is only used for one purpose in the game right now, which is to power your base on the go or your vehicle on the go. And we don't really need that. We have plenty of power being generated right now. So we're going to sell coal for some compounds. You can sell coal for quite a bit of resources from what I've been told. That's only going to take one off right now. I'm not sure how it's going to come back. If it's going to come back with it completely stacked with 4 of the compounds. And if it does do that, I want to make sure that it has room, because we can sell a lot more than just 4 coal if we decide to. There is a spot out here on the map that we're going to be checking out that has a decent amount of resin, so that way I don't have to buy it. I don't have to waste the coal right now. We can use that to get like lithium and things of that sort down the road. And we do have this node out here that will allow us to actually refine and get compounds from it as it recharges. I've already grabbed it all that I can get out of it. And I got, I think, 2.5 little things of a compound out of it after it's been fully charged. So that's kind of nice. And this is the area that I was talking about before that has, it took a little while for that thing to stop. It had some momentum going into it. But yeah, we're going to grab all of this because that planet just doesn't have enough. And I want to go in there and I want to do some research next time we go back. One of the other things we're going to do before we leave is we're going to search the planet's surface just a tiny bit more to see if we can find any different types of new technology before we have to head out there. Now let's seal this back in a little bit just to make sure we don't have to deal with all these potholes all over the surface all the time. It's cool that I got this tool. I wish I had known about it earlier on in the game. My base would have looked so much better. I would have leveled it out. Before we put down this new base on the next planet, we're gonna definitely level it out. Now this thing over here, I don't know if we can drag it back to our base. I don't think we can. I was looking at it to see if maybe we can get the hitch on there. There's nothing to really stick onto it, and I don't really think there's a purpose to doing that. However, if you look in there, you will see that the places where the resources can go are only on the bottom too. The top doesn't seem like you can actually connect anything to it anymore. So yeah, it's kind of broken, guys. It's broken in such a way that it's not really going to be useful to us. Okay, so this is low on energy, so let's head back. We're going to need to pump this back in to the other truck that I have. more trucks, more rovers that you have connected to it, obviously, the more energy it can hold in one go, and the further out you can go before you have to return back to base. And since we're going to be going off and exploring, that's exactly what we need to do, is connect it to our other vehicle, even if we're not going to be doing anything with it. Like this one over here, really, if you look at it, it doesn't have anything to offer us anymore. It's not something... Like, the drill is perfect if we're doing a two-player game and we're going to be going off. But with a single-player game... Come on, guys. Get close. Such a pain in the butt to hook these things up. There you go. Yeah. I wish there was an automatic... Like, when you're in the rover, click a little button and it would automatically connect the two together. Let's see. We need to get this back over here connected to my base. At least until the sun comes out. Let's get over here. Back it up. Somewhat, kind of. There. What can we do with this? Will you let me connect? There you go. And now power is flowing in there. Let's come over here. How many did we get? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many spaces did it have? It has spaces for 2 more. Or 4 more, I should say. So let's snag all of this. We'll put this on our backpack for now. Now, most of this compound is going to go straight on to my backpack in the end. Or, nope, put that back on. Or into the rover itself. Or not the rover, but the spaceship. The bits that I can hold. The rest of it is going to go to making more storage panels that I can put up here and on my my vehicle. Because that is going to be really nice. Let's see. How many can you carry? That's... You're ridiculous. That's not what I want. Doing it on a vehicle or a table that actually uses compounds and is actually trying to make something else with it. Yeah, let's do that. So that's 4 and 4. Should be pretty good. I think so, anyways. Okay, so let's make a few more. Let's do 2 more trips of that. 1 and 2. So that's gonna come back with 8 on there. Let's also tell it to do some fuel here, because we're gonna need a nice supply of this. I have no idea what to do with this egg, guys. It's a new item that I found up there on that planet, and doesn't seem to allow me to do anything with it, so that kind of sucks. We got compounds coming in over here. This thing... let's take this off and put that up there. We're going to connect that rover for more battery power to my little truck over here before we go off and explore for the next, you know, probably about 10-15 minutes. We'll go out there and see what we can find. Let's put this over here. Now, coal is somewhat rare, so it does kind of suck to use it, but at the same time, if you are grabbing these things from the plants, you'll tend to actually find coal. I would say 1 out of every 8 of those you'll find the coal. Come on, get it in there. A little bit more. Can we get it? Can we get it? There we go. Close enough. And generator. Generator could be useful, but we're not going to take that with us right now. There you go. Let's see. Very, very beautiful. Let's... Can we grab that resource? Nope, that's the resource that it is refining at the moment, so we can't even grab that. Okay, let's head back. Our compound is now here. How many do we have? We have 8. You know what? I'm going to leave that there. I'm going to leave the 8 there. That will be my entire backpack's worth. And that is for tethers and other things that we want to explore on that planet so much. Or at least I do. I want to explore on that planet a lot. So let's come out here. Now, we have gone in this direction before, but I don't think we've ever gone, you know, all the way out here to explore what is in the vast reaches. There's some compound right there. Let's go ahead and hop into the, we didn't get really close enough. Let me get a little closer to this, and we'll hop into the excavator there and refine some of this. Here we go. Yeah, dig that sucker up. Woo, baby. Yeah, you know, the angles, camera angles on this one. Come on, get in there. Get all of that yummy goodness. Woo, baby, look at that. That is gonna fill up really quick. Is he gonna go to the next one when it has a chance? Or is he gonna pop it there on the ground? I don't see it going to another one just yet. Could it just be that it doesn't have enough in there? Yep, that looks like everything that I can get out of that one. Whew, we're right there on the line, so hopefully we do not fall over. Come on, drive! Drive, truck! Do it, do it, do it! No, don't fall over! Come on, you can do it! Oh, yes. Alright, we did that. Whew, okay, we might need a little bit of resin too, so let's get over, come over here and see how well this is gonna work. Let's leave that there. I was gonna say, yeah, we can move some of it. Let's leave it there. I want to get definitely see if this will. Ah, so it dropped that one off even though it wasn't completely done yet. Ah, and it's dropping that one off too. Okay, well, I think we found that out before, but kind of forget these things unless you do it a lot. Yeah, buddy, look how fast that does it. So much better of a camera angle on this one than the last one. I can actually see what I'm doing. Here we go. A little bit more. A little bit more. Oh, no. It's a lot more. Yep, yep, a lot more. And it's right next to me, too. How about way over here? Anything? Nope. That looks like it. And we might lose one of those resources down there. Let's snag these. Now, if we had those containers, those portable ones, we'd be able to get a little bit more. Can't use that. Won't ever be able to use that one. Let's snag one of these and put them up here. And so we have six more spaces. Six more spaces. That gives me a little bit of room for research if we happen to come across one or two new pieces of technology. So we probably won't do too much digging past this point. Okay, so we're going to be going out there. There's a little bit more resin over here. Lots of resources on the surface. Keep going, dude. You can do it. What is this? Okay, so we've chopped this tree down before. Definitely been over here. What about over here next to these rocks? These rocks right here always make me think there might be something underneath them. If you dig under there, I'm expecting to find, like, you know, pirate's treasure. I want to see landmarks in this game that look like other things that get your interest and just be like, oh, what is that, right? Like, I want to go into that. I want to search this compound of somebody else's fallen base. Almost, oh, you know what would be cool? A multiplayer to this game, which is random people. Actually be able to go in and just be like, hey, this is a multiplayer world. You can have up to, you know, 16, 200 people, whatever. And as you go through it, you could build bases. If you die, other people can come and loot them. If you leave resources there on there, they're just there for anybody to take. It makes it to where you might have to, like, protect your base. Maybe give you some way of locking down your resources or even hiding them. Maybe even going so far as to create vehicles and then stick them in the earth and cover them up with a doorway that you would have to, like, redig every single time so that when you come back, your resources are still there. Unless somebody finds your stash and makes off with all your booty. I think that would be kind of a cool concept. They might go down that route. I don't know. I haven't heard anything along those lines, so it's probably not going to happen. But I don't know. I just, thinking about multiplayer with video games nowadays, multiplayer seems to be where a lot of people love to spend their time. And of course, this one has it. You can invite friends that you know on Steam and they can come in there and help your world out. But I think if you could open it up to everybody, just like random people, you'd get a good mix of craziness. You could see some incredible things being built, almost like Minecraft. The more, you know, zany and crazy the population, the community is, the more outrageous this stuff can get. Now, we're going to be running out of energy here in just a minute, so we might have to turn back around or wait for the sun to come out. There's some compounds over there. Come on, go, go, go. We're low on lawn power, low on power. That's why we're moving really slow. Oh, no, okay, so we're being fed from behind. We just need to find, like, a power node. And there's the solar reactor, so it lasted just long enough. Still haven't seen any crashed spaceships. They're just supposed to be laying here on the surface. We did get lucky there for a while, and there's another node over here. But look at that, there's a little ravine. I don't want to go anywhere near that. And there's some power over there. Might snag a little bit of that if we could actually get across that. It's like our mini Grand Canyon. Once you get to the other side, good luck getting back. Oh, and there we go. We got a crashed ship, guys. That is exactly what we're looking for. And I can guarantee you, we have never been out this far. Come on, book it. Get there. What do you have? Let's cut it out right here. Let that have some time to recharge so it's ready for us later on. And I will use my own power here to excavate this in a nice, orderly way. Looks like we got a chair in there. They seem to always come with at least one chair. Oh, man. There's not going to be anything else in here, is there? Maybe around it. We'll get lucky. Okay, so what do we got here? We got a chair. Let's throw that up there. We got some lithium, so we'll throw that on there. Copper. Compound. And aluminum, so basically a little bit of everything, just everything a growing boy needs. Come on, there we go. Alright, where are we gonna put this? Can we not put it up there? I would love to see somebody writing in that, just like willy-nilly on the side. Oh yes, here we go. Here's some tech. Yeah, baby, that's what we wanted. That makes the whole trip. Can we put it back there? You guys don't want to... There you go. Oh, no, that didn't go on. So we got space for two more, or one more research. One more research. Let's keep digging. Make sure we didn't miss anything. I've come out to the one that was next to my base a couple of times, and every single time I go out to it, I seem to find, like, one more little piece of stuff I didn't see before. And usually it's just junk. It's kind of this stuff that's broken off and just sitting there, but... You know, you get lucky and you might find what you're looking for. I don't think there's anything else in here, but we'll give it one more once over and we'll dig it all out. This would be cool, though, if you could fix these at some point. Fix these and use these as your space shuttle. Because they did give you a small shuttle and then they give you a larger shuttle, an actual spaceship. And this looks like the next step. Look how many resources you'd be able to throw into that sucker. Even if you didn't put it down on those little list, those little spots, you'd just be able to throw them in there randomly and close the door. And then when you open it up later on, it all comes out falling out like little balls that you need to use right away or risk maybe the wind blowing them out. But that would be worth it when you're setting up a base. Maybe a little too easy, to be honest. I mean, that's a lot of resources you'd be able to take. But it would take a long time to get to that point, unless you just got super lucky. What is that out there? Is that just plants? Yeah, it's just plants. Okay. Don't know what this is. This is kind of a weird looking plant. Let's see if we can dig underneath it and see what we find here. What is going to be at the bottom? Can I not click on that? It's completely dug out now. Can we click on it? Yeah, but it looks just like a regular plant. I thought maybe there'd be something different there. Now, those things can give you research as well, but from what people have been watching on my Let's Play and commenting, they believe I've gotten all the technology that I'm going to be able to get from plants. So they're saying I should concentrate a little bit more on the rest of it, which is these crashed spaceships. So we're going to start swinging a little bit to the left, and we're going to make a giant circle back if I can get over these rocks that happen to be causing me some issues. Again, another upgrade would be nice. A bigger version of the truck that can get over these rocks. Now, most people might be like, well, you know, you can just flatten out the land. That is technically true. You can flatten the ground out. However, these rocks come back because I built an entire section. Ah, there's a spaceship out here. Nice. Yeah, I built an entire section of brand new land. And the next time I load it back into my game after a few of the dust storms, rocks had resurfaced all over it. There we go. And it does look... That's not what I wanted. It does look like there might be technology. No, that's not technology. What do you got inside you, my friend? You got fuel, hydrogen, and we got titanium. We can't do anything with this, can we? I don't think we can. Oh, nothing there. All right, let's get this on the back. All right, that's not what I was looking for. I want the technology, guys. Yeah, but just making one last glance over and make sure I'm not missing it, kind of sticking out of the ground. But I don't see it. Okay, anything off in the distance over there? Not really. At least not what I can see. And I have my graphics turned up all the way. What is that? Rocks? Have we seen a plant like this before? What is that? I don't think we've seen a plant like this, so let's dig under there. Yeah, it's just a regular plant though. Okay. Ships, no ships. Okay, we're gonna go a little bit further out here. We're gonna go to that mountain and then take a left and start working our way back. Oh wow, look at that. That's even deeper than the last one that we found. Might have to flatten over to get there. Cross the other side. Wow, that is a big cave. I like it. And it would definitely protect you from the sandstorms. If you happen to get caught out here, that would be really, really nice protection for you. Oh, come on, guys. Stupid rocks. I'm blaming the rocks over here, but it really is just pilot error. You know, I'm kind of manhandling my way through all this, and what I really should be doing is actually driving it, just kind of looking at the ground. I'm looking off in the distance and not kind of right in front of me. And because of that, I'm hitting like everything. I love the wind though, when it's like blowing the leaves or whatever this grass is on the ground. I don't see anything out here. It's the most barren part of the world as far as resources go. See some energy right there. I don't see anything over there. Dang it. Come on. Well, one is good. One is good, two would have been better, three would have been fantastic. That's all I was hoping for, is maybe two. Maybe two. And we could still get lucky. Ah, come on, compounds. It's supposed to be light and airy, fluffy for me to like run right over. And you know, compounds, what they could do is make you make them. You know, it sounds like it's a man-made thing. So make it where you have to get resin and... I don't know what else you could get, because compounds are used in a lot of things. Maybe resin and organic, and mix them together in a machine, and you could make compounds out of it. Because, you know, resin is somewhat rare, and organic is incredibly plentiful, depending on the planet you're on. So when you first start off, you'd be able to make as much compound as you really need. But then later on, you'd just be like, man, it's not easy to make that anymore. And if you wanted to, like, keep the nodes in there... Maybe put the compounds around the crash spaceships so that it makes kind of somewhat sense that the compounds from the vehicle have been broken down maybe by microorganisms or blown apart from the spaceship itself, and now they're just kind of laying there on the ground next to it, ready for you to mine. I don't see the marker for our base, so we're very, very... Oh, there it is out there in the distance, maybe? Nope, those are falling snowflakes, giving me false hope. So let's start turning a little bit to the left around this mountain and see if we can find our way home. Oh man, there is nothing. think we've gone too far, right? I hope. This is what happens when you're not paying attention, when you're too busy looking. They need a map, too. They need a radar that actually works. When you put down those homing beacons, to me, a homing beacon means you can home in on it somehow. You really can't. You have to get pretty close, almost within visual of the homing beacon, which is kind of ridiculous. I mean, there's a spaceship out there, so let's go check that out. But yeah, if you have to get within visual, then there's no real point in me having it, because I could do that anyways, just visually. So I want a radar so I can put those homing beacons down and I can see them from further away. Maybe not infinite, you know, give me some distance on it, but like I need something. Oh yes, technology, I see it already. That is what we're going after. Oh, that's not technology. Dang it, got my hopes up. What do you got inside you, my friend? What is it? Titanium, it looks like. Some copper. A little bit of organic in there. I don't really need any of that, so we're just gonna leave that there. We don't have a lot of space on us. We're almost completely out. Let's do one little pass over this area. Make sure we're not missing anything. Yeah, I guess it's just the big ones. Really hoping it would be more of the smaller ones. You find a lot more of those around. Actually, let me dig that. I was gonna say I was just gonna leave it there, but it could be like a bigger version of something underground. And I'm paranoid. I'm gonna leave something. Okay. Storm clouds. Oh man, we might be lost. What do you do if you get lost? Just die? If you die, I guess you get zapped back to your base, but you have to leave everything behind. And I ain't leaving this technology behind. I'll travel out here for a few hours trying to find my base before I even think about doing that. Because unless you brought one of those capsules with you, you can't start over. I can't build anything off of this thing. Yeah, because if I could go up into space, I could get my bearings. I could see where we were when I left, and I could see where we are when we come back. And then be like, okay, I need to go south, southeast, or I need to go to the left or the right, or, you know, really sharp angle. But right now, I am not recognizing any of this stuff. So let's go around this mountain. We'll make another left once we get to the other side. Nope, that is... Thought that little blue thing out there in the distance to the right was my homing beacon, but nope, not the case. Aw, oh, come on, guys. Okay, let's fix this real quick. Come on, get in there. Now, when the guy's in the second seat, one of the things I would love to be able to see is for him not only to be able to dig, but for him to be able to do something like this with one of the tools. That way, if you do run across something like this, the driver doesn't necessarily have to get out, and neither does the passenger. Like, I want them to be able to... There we go. Get that over there. Need to be able to connect this. Come on, come on. It's a little bit higher. What's it doing? Why is it digging straight down? Okay, so... It's not merging as well as I was hoping it would. Ah, jeez. Okay, so we're gonna have to raise this up a little bit and then level it out somehow. How about get in there? Get in there, my precious. Doesn't have to be perfect, just needs to be doable for us to get across. Okay. So now if we maybe level this. Oh, that was absolutely horrible. But I think we might be able to get across it. So let's give it a shot. Go, go. Oh, and there's a crashed spaceship out there in the distance. So maybe not our main base, but, you know, we're getting closer to our goal of two or three. I'm pretty sure something this big is going to have one, too. Gimme, 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 gimme. Where is it on the ground? There it is. That is it. Yeah. That is exactly what we're looking for. So let's drive away from it. We can dig underneath it at our leisure. Oh, so beautiful. Come on, Resin, get back on there. You, on the other hand, is what I am after. And it looks like we got another chair. Come on, get on there. Ooh, yeah, so one goes sideways, one goes up and down, so they are different materials. Nothing there. What about over here? Anything good? Nope, nope. Okay, what about you? What do you got inside? You got a chair? You know, I got plenty of chairs. I don't need another one. In fact, if I ever run across another research material, I'll leave the chair I have and take the research material. Nope, nothing there either. Alright, let's head out. Now our goal, find my base. Find my base before my guy starves out here. We do have plenty of organic. I guess he could survive. He could eat whatever it is that we keep finding. Oh, and there's another satellite. There's another satellite. I could have brought my winch with me. I didn't think about it. I didn't think we'd run across a satellite out here. I thought there was only a few of them on the map, and this is definitely a surprise to find one of these. Of course, it would have made it an absolute nightmare to travel back with this thing in tow. These things are, like, hideous when it comes to moving. We might try connecting it, though, to the rover. Because you can connect it for power purposes. Might be able to be dragged that way, too. Then again, probably not. But we'll give it a shot. We'll just dig it out. That's not going to cost us anything to do except for a little bit of time. So we'll dig that out completely. There you go. Once it starts moving, you know it's free. And we will come over here. Oh, we got another. Yes. Got another research module. So let's snag that. If it will let us. Come on, get in there. There we go. Not really. And we are going to have to get rid of our chair or some of our resources. Let's see. What do we want to get rid of? Man, I really don't want to get rid of anything there. I guess we're going to get rid of the chair. We'll make more if we have to. We'll leave that there. Let's come over here. Can we flip this? Can we move it? That isn't anything, right? No. Can we push it? Come on, push. Oh, not quite. Let me see if we can push it again. Now, you can get in the truck, I know for sure. I'm gonna try to do it without the truck getting in the way. Come on, nope. All right, let's use the truck. See if we can bully this thing into place. Ooh, buddy. Might be able to use the arm too. Just kind of push it with the arm. All right, I'm gonna see if we can back it up. Not gonna happen, but come on, back straight up. Back. Ah, come on, you were so close too. There we go. Back. A little closer, trucky. How about now? Can we? You do not like to go back. Reverse is not an option. About, because you'll see it when it connects, when it gets close. It will leave that little line. Okay, how about now? Come on. You know what? We are going to see if that's good enough. If it is possible to do it, it would be possible to do it now. And it's not. Nah, it's not gonna let us do it. Actually, let's dig out a little bit. Let this kind of fall down into place. If I can see where my little guy is. There we go. Come on. Nice. Is it going to travel with us? That is going to be the question. I think it's just going to tear right off. Is it powering up? Yeah, it is. It's powering me up. So let's give it a second to power up all of my power before, or all my batteries, I should say, before we take off. And that way, if we have to leave it behind, at least we got some juice out of it. But I think we have to head that way, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, close? Pretty close. All right, let's do it. Nope. Yep, yeah, you gotta have that winch to move it. You can connect to it, but you can't... You can't move it that way. Well, it was worth a shot. Now we know. And as they say in G.I. Joe, guys, knowing is half the battle. Jeez. I used to watch that cartoon when I was a kid all the time. And... Oh my god, another one? Well, we are definitely going over there. We're gonna go back with a lot more than I thought we were gonna have. Okay, so we need a flat surface from over here. Let's go over, keep going. I'm not trying to make it look pretty, I just need it to work. So if it got a little bit of holes in there, I'm not too worried. There we go, that should be good. Yes, come on, come on, come on. Turn around this, this tree that's definitely gonna get in my way. What do you got inside that mountain, my friend? They had a lot of crashes on their planet. I hope they come up with a storyline for this. Like, there's a game like TerraTech that I play, and that one is really, really cool because the storyline is there's, like, corporations that are vying for control over the resources of that planet, and they could do something like that for this one, where that's why there's so many crashed ships, and it's all just, you know... The first come, first serve, everybody out for themselves, and nobody really comes out here to look for these survivors or the fallen resources because they're just like, let's move on and get our resources, you know, mine the planet as quick as possible before the next group gets in there. Oh, man. This is going to be deep, deep going in there, and I have no power left. All right, let's take a look around. What are we going to get? You know, nothing fantastic, nothing that's gonna blow me away. Really wanted some more research. Do I see any kind of just sticking out of the mountain? No, I don't. I don't see any more resources sticking out of the mountain over here. Oh, that sucks. Well, guys, I think we're gonna go ahead and end the episode here. I am, of course, going to continue my journey back to my base. Hopefully we can find it. I think we can. And if we find any more of the stuff on the way, then we'll definitely snag it. Even if I have to get rid of all my resources and just use research as my storage capacity, that's going to be worth it in its own right. However, the one thing I won't get rid of, no matter how much I want to or how much I need to for the research, is my solar reactor. Without that, we will not have any power. We'll be having to stop every 2 or 3 seconds and grabbing some energy off of the ground or off of some of these nodes, and that's just going to be so time-consuming. I don't think it would be worth it. So having either a windmill or a solar reactor on here, I think, is key. It allows you to go further and stay like a constant push, especially if you have enough of these caravans, enough of these trucks and rovers behind you to store the power you need during the day. And if you're not using it to dig, so much the better. Oh, we found another one, just random. And it looks like there's two or three here. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm glad we stayed recording right there. And there's another one right here. Holy crap, guys, two more. That is nuts. Okay, well, can we put one on the front? We can. Can we put one on the back? That's going to be the store. Oh, no. Did it go underground? No, we lost it. You suck. No, that happened to me once before. That is heartbreaking. Oh, man. You know what? We just didn't let it realize there was a ground until too late. Like, it was already in the movement phase, and then we put it... We let go too soon. That sucks. We got one, though. I guess I shouldn't be too disappointed with it. But we could have got two out of that, guys. Could have got two. And we didn't. I'm disappointed, guys. I'm disappointed. And now I can't even move. I'm so disappointed I'm frozen in place. But okay, guys, as I said before, I want to thank you all for watching. If you do guys have tips, let me know. I'm going to do a little bit of searching in between this episode and the next. I might do a little bit of building, but I will save the research, the actual what we get out of them for the video so that you guys can watch the beauty and the sheer randomness of that little thing just kind of going through its slot machine phase and figuring out for us what we're going to get. As always, guys, I'm AC Gamer, and I will definitely catch you all next time. Hey, guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.